Welcome back, you guys. Today, I'm gonna show you how I make my moss pole, which is fortified with a PVC pipe, and it's stackable. You would be hearing the neighbor's generator because the power is out here since this morning, and ours isn't running. I have a huge sack of moss. I sell these moss poles to pretty much just my friends. I sell the moss poles, so it's better to get moss per sack. Just make sure when you're getting moss, check, because sometimes they get really dark and brown. They're no good. This is how I do it. So I line the mesh with moss. And then I line it with more moss. I don't wet it, cause it's just easier for me to do it this way. So basically we just cut the mesh into size. This is 4 feet tall moss pole. And just fill it with moss, like what I'm doing. The moss disintegrate over time. So make sure you're packing it with moss. So it's sad. Alright, it's gonna be messy. You need to put something under if you're making it indoors, just so you won't have to clean a lot of moss on the floor. You just do it like this. Test if it's enough. Now, of course, we need to cover the PVC because it's not pretty. At least for me. See? The rooster is agreeing. It's fine if you could still see the PVC because the moss would be squeezed in. And, of course, we need cable ties. This is just 5 millimeters by 100 millimeters cable ties. You can buy it from your local hardware store. Doesn't have to be fancy. I put cable ties every 3 squares of the mesh. Just gonna fill in a little bit at the bottom. And here. Actually, I don't have to, because I need it when I extend it later. Now we just need to this. I'm gonna get cap for the ends. I just use this to close the bottom, and I'm bend it. So it's also a mesh, a bit thinner, and gauge. I just put it at the end. to kind of finish this, but I will keep the other end open for extending it later. You know, when I first made moss poles, I did not intend on selling them. So I pretty much just made them for myself at first. Then when clients come here, they see the moss poles, how pretty they look. They want me to make moss poles for them. So I just started making moss poles for clients when they order. So I only make moss poles when I have orders. I've got an order for 5 pieces of 4 feet. So it makes a way for this video. Now where's my cutter? So to clean this, we just cut the cable ties like so. And then turn it inside, just so it won't scratch you. You just turn where I cut it, I turn it inside. Of course, I'm gonna clean this too. I don't normally cut the cables. My husband does this for me, especially if I have a bulk order of moss poles. So he cleans the cable ties and do the finishing touches most of the time. But he's behind the camera, so I will do it just for this video. Moss poles or any kind of stakes are really good for your climbing aroids. You would turn it like this, just so it won't be sharp when the client holds it. There. That's why I'm wearing gloves, so it won't break my skin. As I was saying, moss pole is a good support, or any kind of stake. They're a good support for your climbing plants. Because plants, when they're like the philodendron paraisiverde, they just want to climb. And they go crazy. And if you give them something to climb onto, they push out bigger leaves, which of course goes for us plant parents. So this is pretty much done. This is an extendable moss ball. This is actually my new design. Before when I extend the moss pole, I need to make it one size smaller, but this one I just need a coupling for the PVC that I use inside, and it's gonna be more sturdy when I extend this. It would be a lot easier. See you on the next one. Gently tap that notification bell and the subscribe button. And I'll see you on the next one.